Conor McGregor's been up some funny business yet again, making sure the entire world knows that Irish people are just a bunch of heavy drinkers. What can I say? Irish people love the crack. Not that kind. Andrew Tate, Mr. Top G himself. Is he planning to box Jake Paul? Surprised he doesn't want to box a woman, really. A bunch of TikTokers set up a boxing event, and well, it didn't really go that well, did it? And speaking of cracks, sorry, Paddy. Yeah. And there's plenty of cream poison Love Island this week. And without further ado, welcome to another week on planet Earth. Conor McGregor's been getting in some mischief recently. Conor turned 34 last week. And to celebrate in true McGregor fashion, he bit up a few outlads tonight. And I'm just joking. He held a massive party over in Ibiza. And just so you're wondering, the wife did go, yeah? Wouldn't stop him from cheating, though, would it? Now, they call Conor notorious in the octagon. But Christ almighty above, is he notorious on a night out? So you know the way Conor has a lovely yacht? Massive thing, like. So one of the downsides of owning a multi-million euro yacht is women might get injured on it. All they have to do is scream, and they make a Netflix documentary about you. So a woman was injured on McGregor's boat, and they were very quickly to put out that it wasn't Conor himself that was touching up the woman, surprisingly enough. It was actually Dee Devlin, Conor's wife. Also, a day before that, some fella threw a hat at Conor. Conor was raging. So this fan basically got into his party in Ibiza in true Jake Paul fashion, taking the hat off, throwing it at Conor, just to get a bit of a reaction, and Conor was fuming. Now, bearing in mind, he's probably after a few whiskeys himself. Like I said, the Irish people love the cracks. So he's probably high on narcotics. Conor wasn't having none of it. He's been out of the UFC now for over a year, trying to get some practice in, stamping on it. Couldn't stamp on Dustin Poirier, though, could he? So it was a wild weekend for Conor McGregor and the whole family. I took the time to go back and watch a Notorious documentary on Netflix. This is not an advertisement. Netflix wouldn't touch me with a 10-foot pole. Oh, but when a little girl goes missing, should Jesus get all the cameras out? Fucking Madeline. I've never actually seen the Notorious documentary, so I was like, okay, I'll give it a watch. Very, very good documentary. If you haven't watched, I definitely highly recommend you go watch it if you're a Conor McGregor fan. I find it so interesting when someone from Ireland actually goes away and makes a name for themselves and takes off. So a big respect to Conor. You know, he's done some controversial stuff like hitting out a lad, but look, we've all been there. Boris Johnson, what a man. What an absolute lad. So Boris Johnson retired. Basically, well, he's not going to get another job in the entire United Kingdom. He couldn't even work in McDonald's. He stepped down as Prime Minister after all the lockdown parties and the twerking and stuff. I found it a bit outrageous. Obviously, when you make the rules and you break them, it's a bit bad, like, for the public perception of you as the Prime Minister. But, like, it's not as if you send the news to underage women. I've seen the royal family do 10 times worse, and they love the royal family over there. Now, there's a political commentator called Jonathan Pye. He absolutely despises Boris Johnson. Let's take a look at it.
So he's gone. He's fucked off then. He's resigned. Okay, so he's resigned, but he hasn't fucked off. Okay. Fucking, I mean, what do we have to do? Wait for another few months whilst he takes the wallpaper down? I'm loving this. What an exit. The Prime Minister forgot that his whip was a sexual predator. No answer to that one. A Prime Minister who is as adept at lying at the dispatch box as he is to his string of mistresses. Every marriage Boris has had has ended when he fucked someone else and got them pregnant. That's who he is. Lies on top of lies on top of lies. He lies and gets people to lie on his behalf and then lies about the lying. And when he runs out of lies, he can always rely on the incompetence card. I forgot. I can't remember. I don't understand what the word party means. My willy just ended up inside my secretary.
Good old Jonathan, lad, you can't go wrong. But being Irish, it was class looking over at Boris Johnson just completely destroy Great Britain. Just tremendous, like, you know. You get what you voted for. You wanted Brexit, and instead you got Boris Johnson. So, TikTokers had a boxing event. Obviously, it wasn't on the same standard as the YouTube events like KSI, Joe Weller, Jake Paul, etc. Let's just say it didn't go well. The production was fine. It wasn't particularly terrible. Like, I don't even know the boys who were headlining the event or co-main fighting the event. If it wasn't for the Irish TikToker, I don't think I'd have a clue who any of them were. AJ Bunker and L Brook. I actually had to read their names. Don't have a clue there. They were co-main event. And I won't lie, it was £7. I think £8. I wasn't really going to be buying that, was I? But there was a couple of funny moments. Even if you played box on the Wii back 15 years ago, you'd have some bit of like a cop on how to throw a punch. Luke got into the cage and within 15 seconds he was like, nah, the ref waved it off, lad.
Bennett's famous phrase, is that the right word?
Yeah, but he's turned away. He's not wanting this.
I don't think he wants to be in there. I don't think he needs. I think he's had enough.
Body language says it all. This I think is the
ref should probably wave this one off.
Tyrone, I think if Dean comes in hard and fast one more time, it'll be all over. But he's giving every indication. Yes. You're right, Tyrone. Good call. Tyrone called it.
The ref had to wave that one off.
And that wasn't even the funniest part of the night. You had Paddy Murphy, Cecile the Cavman. Basically, he's an Irish TikToker, but he's into the football as well. Do you know the way I said the Irish people love their crack? Well, Paddy took it to the next level.
Yeah.
Not great, that, in fairness. But sure, look, at least he's able to laugh about it. Oh, lads, honestly. $6.99 that cost. I'm actually very excited to see YouTube Boxing back again. Alex Wasabi versus KSI on the 27th of August. There's something really special. I remember being in school, legally this time, obviously. I remember being in school and, like, you know, the end of summer, you'd have, like, the YouTube boxing events, especially in, like, second and third year. I won't lie, I kind of missed them. Like, this whole Jake Paul stuff, I'm not really into it, really. Jake Paul, Conor McGregor, and all the boys. But no, I'm looking forward to seeing KSI versus Alex. I think he'll absolutely destroy him. He looks in insane shape. Speaking of Jake Paul, Andrew Tate, Mr. Top G himself, called out Jake on his Emergency Meeting podcast. If you don't know who Andrew Tate is, he's basically the male version of Kim Kardashian. You know the way all the women look up to Kim Kardashian? Oh my God, what an arse like. I want an arse like that someday. Andrew Tate is basically the same thing, only for men. His opinions are a bit radical. They're a bit insane. Like, he basically called out Jake Paul on his recent podcast. When I saw the headline, Jake Paul emergency meeting, I immediately thought, okay, Nick Crumpton's fucking dead. But yeah, would you like to see Jake versus Andrew Tate? I think he'd be fairly interesting, considering he was he a kickboxer, Andrew, or something like that? In other news, the Minions are taking over planet Earth. That was meant to be the title for this video, by the way. The Minions are taking over planet Earth for the first episode. Literally, man, I've not seen a movie take over cinema like that in a long, long time. Everyone was hyping up this movie. I even wanted to go and see it. I didn't. I'm barred from most of the cinemas. It's wrong for wearing skirts. I'd love to be bent over by a crew. When the Minions go banana, you know, get a bit aroused. The Minions basically took over TikTok for the week. You had boys walking the place in suits going to the cinema looking like absolute plonkers. Here's the clip.
Here's something you've never seen. Teens dressed to the nines just to go to the movies. Yep, these high schoolers are getting dressed in their Sunday best to see Minions, The Rise of Gru.
Oh, we do love the Minions. TwitchCon happened last weekend as well, over in Amsterdam. Yeah, love that. When you go to Amsterdam, you're just like, yeah, strippers, hookers, you know. Amsterdam's a great city, by the way. If you've not been there, highly would recommend it. If you're looking for a shag, £1.50. But you know, TwitchCon's great. If you're not into Twitch, it's basically where you go and you watch, you know, e-dates, Fortnite. And there's a lot of e-dating on Twitch, which is basically dating over the internet and never seeing each other in real life. I've seen this wonderful story of two e-daters meeting for the first time at TwitchCon, giving each other a lovely hug, man. It was gorgeous, like, tremendous. Probably the most awkward hug I've ever seen in my life. And I've been to Disneyland, where Mickey Mouse greets you at the front door. If you like Twitch, if you watch Twitch, twitch.tv/JakeMcBoss, link in the description down below. We're live every day there around 8 o'clock. Might as well come drop in. There was a load of cream pies in Love Island this week.
I've hired this guy because clearly he has bad opinions about me. And clearly you aren't a true fan, so.
I don't usually tune into Love Island, but when I seen cream pies, it's like, yeah, grand job. OnlyFans wasn't doing it for me this week, so, you know. ITV, tell you, it was the oddest wank I've ever had. Went straight from Love Island to The Chase. All over Anne Hegarty's face. In local news, Limerick won the All-Ireland. Hurling is basically like cricket, only mixed with football, mixed with rugby. Class sport. It is good crack. And obviously, if you've been living underneath a rock, it's been absolutely roasting. We had 30 degrees there the other day, lad. I couldn't even walk out the front door. I was destroyed. I was actually mangled by the heat. But there was a massive fire there in the M25 over in England. And this tweet caught my eye from Mr. Stephen Klopp. One of my favourite Twitter accounts, actually. What a guy. And that's basically everything that happened this week on planet Earth. Right, hope you enjoyed that. If you did, make sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Want to try out something different, something new, something fresh for the channel, just to, like, you know, give me something to do every week. Because obviously, if you watch my TikTok, I do this every week on TikTok anyway. So I want to do, like, a longer version of it. If you liked it, please drop a like, comment down below for a part two. Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, all that stuff, link in the description down below. I'll talk to you at the next one. Cheers for watching. It's long a fold.